Hey developers, so today we're looking at Snowpack. It's the faster front-end build tool. I'll explain what it is, and we'll see how we can get it running with Vue.js and why you may want to use it on your next project. Oh yeah, and we'll also take a look at Vite and see a little bit about the differences between the two and see how we can use both in different apps. Hey, and if you don't know, my name is Eric. I'm a full-stack software developer. I'm also a big fan of Vue.js. Hey, and if you're interested in Vue.js, I actually have a couple of free cheat sheets that you can get. I'll put a link in the description below. Just click on it. You'll sign up for my newsletter. I'll update you when I have new videos, and you'll also get this cool new cheat sheet. So let's talk about Snowpack. Now, Snowpack is the faster front-end build tool. That is the tagline they go by. And so what is Snowpack is? Snowpack is a lightning-fast front-end build tool designed for the modern web. It is an alternative to heavier, more complex bundlers like Webpack or Parcel in your development workflow. So I've seen this a lot. There's this kind of movement to go with no bundler and to make development really, really quick, to have like lightning fast starts of our development servers. And this is plays into it. There's also something called Vite, which I think I have to mention, because Vite also has the same kind of concept where it's an opinionated web dev build tool that serves your code via native ES module imports during dev and bundles and it with rollup for production. So it's lightning fast, cold start. It has HMR support, true on-demand compilation. So this Snowpack, it kind of reminds me a lot of Vite. Snowpack actually came first, I believe. Now Snowpack is up to version 3, and Vite has been being updated all the time too. But it's just ways to create a faster dev tool, so a faster build environment for you is kind of, I think, one of the greatest things it has going for it. So like instant startup, build once, cache forever. So it has this really fast cache system. It has this HMR. I'm not going to explain what HMR is, but that's like hot module replacement. So it's just really fast. Out of the box support for like JSX, TypeScript, React. By the way, nowhere on the front page of Snowpack doesn't mention Vue at all, which I'm sad that it doesn't have that on there. So I'll explain to you how you can create an app using Snowpack with Vue. It's really easy. It's optimized for production, so you can build it for production, and it has plugins. So probably a very common question that you might have is, what's the difference between Snowpack and a tool like Vite? Now, Vite has basically support from Evan Yu, the creator of Vue.js, but let's take a look. There is a section at the bottom, like what the difference between Snowpack and Vite are. And essentially what it says, during the development of Vite, like there wasn't as good of HMR support in Snowpack, so it came into later versions of it. So Vite actually had that right away. Both solutions can bundle an app for production, but Vite uses rollup with built-in config, while Snowpack delegates it to Parcel Webpack. So that's one difference between the two. The most cases build faster and produces smaller bundles. So if you are a Vue.js purist and you want to try to get the smallest bundle size, Vite claims to have the smallest bundle size. During my tests, I was just creating some very simple apps. They were really, really close. I really didn't see any difference. But I can imagine when you have larger Vue apps that if bundle size is extremely important, which it should be, then you may want to go with Vite. And then also, it's basically first-class feature support with Vue for Vite. So it's going to be something it's going to be provided and supported for a long time. And you may not know this, but you can actually use, there is templates for Vite for Preact and React as well, not just Vue. Now Snowpack definitely can be used a lot of different ways too. Now the quick start guide in Snowpack, I'm not going to go through the quick start guide, but you can do this npm install, and you can do npx Snowpack, and that's basically has a CLI that uses to create apps. And what I'm going to use today to get up and running is I'm going to use the Create Snowpack App CLI, and there actually is a template for Vue, which makes it really simple to start. If you look back, there's a lot of templates for Snowpack, much more than Vite. So versatility, Snowpack seems to have a lot more going for it, if you're definitely looking for more than just React, Preact, and Vue. But you can see here, Svelte is pretty popular in the Snowpack. Preact, React, looks like a bunch of TypeScript support as well. While on the Vite side, it's not quite as many. You can see here, just Vue with TypeScript, React, React with TypeScript, Preact, Preact with TypeScript, and Reason React. So to get started, we're going to use this this template for Vue. So I have here open up VS Code, and this I'm using version 14 of Node, but you can usually use Yarn too. To get started, just like every single CLI tool, it starts with create. So create Snowpack app, and then the name of the apps, we're going to call it Snowpack example. And then you do dash dash template, and then you put in the name of the template. In this case, for this one, it's going to be the app template view. So I'll put in app template view. Oops, I actually need to do at Snowpack slash. Otherwise, it's not going to be in the right place. So this will just take a moment. All right, so we went ahead and did it for us. So in our Snowpack example folder, we have our app.view file. And this is a Vue 3 app, by the way. If you look at the package.json, you can see here, this is sort of, it's really simple. You can see here, it has the Snowpack plugin.dev, Snowpack plugin Vue, but which, by the way, it's using the Vue front, a bunch of Vue libraries to make this Snowpack plugin Vue to do everything it needs to do. And use the Snowpack, and it's using version Vue 3. And you can see here, we have a start, build, and test. So if I go ahead and change directory into my Snowpack folder and then do, I guess you can't see that. So if I can, so I'm inside the folder now, so I can do npm run, and I can do npm run start, and that should run Snowpack. And you see right away it started. It took like half a second. So now if I go localhost 8080, oops, let me do this again. Here it is. You can see it's running already, and it just took like half a second. And if I make any changes to this, let's say I don't know, change the word of this to 2. You see file change, and it just instantly updated. So it's super duper fast. It's up and running for me. And if I wanted to at this point, you can see here's some configuration for the hot module HMR stuff. But I could add in Vue Router. I could add in anything else I want to create a fully featured app in here. And if I run npm run build, let's see here, npm run build, this will go ahead and create the build for Snowpack for me, and it'll create a folder called build. And you can see here, here's the index file, here's all the files for you ready to go, and you could just copy that to wherever you need it. So that's it. That's as easy as it is to start with Snowpack. Now, Vite, on the other hand, we just do the same thing. We can do Vite create Vite app, and then the app name, which I'm going to call Vite example. And this will just take a moment, and it'll go ahead and create a Vite app. So it's a little bit faster, but it doesn't do the npm install. So I'm going to go to the directory, and then do npm I, or do yarn, and this will go ahead and install the dependencies. And this will just take a moment. All right, so it finished. So now I just need to do npm run dev, and this will start the Vite app. And once again, it just starts up very, very quickly. So now the Vite app is running on port 3000, hello 3.0 Vite. And if I go into that folder, public, let's see, source, app view, it has this hello world. If I make a change here, edit 123, save it. It's really, really quick. You can see here right away it changed it. So, you know, another really good example of using both Vite and Snowpack is that they're just super duper quick. I think that's like the number one selling point of changing from Vue CLI to something like Vite or Snowpack, is if you're just trying to quickly create a prototype of something, these apps are great, and then it still builds for you. So in Vite, to build, you can do npm run build, and that'll go ahead and create the production bundle. And obviously I have a very simple app. It just takes a second. And that will create this dist folder. And then your dist folder has your fab icons and your index HTML and everything you need in it. So you can see right here, it's just really simple. And it uses Brotli, and it makes them really, really, really small. So yeah, that's it between these two. I just wanted to show kind of an alternative way of using like this no bundler systems with Snowpack. Now, if I had to choose between using Snowpack and Vite, I would definitely probably still go with Vite for Vue, because it has, if this was something I really want to do, because it's officially supported by Vue. It's super duper fast, and it claims to have smaller bundle sizes, which is exactly what you want. But if I was kind of on a team that was already using Snowpack, or we had multiple apps and Snowpack, like if I was in a team that's like, okay, we want to go to this no bundle way of doing things, we don't want to use Vue CLI, then I would be like, Snowpack is great because we can not just do Vue, but if we were using React, Svelte, or anything like that, it has a lot of different plugins. It works pretty well. So I might consider using Snowpack instead. I think things are going to be changing. I think there's going to be more cool stuff coming out. I think people are getting a little bit sick of Webpack and its complexities, and they're just looking for alternatives. And since now browsers support ESM out of the box, that there's kind of cooler ways of doing web development and having really fast development servers. So let me know what you think in the comments below. Maybe I can even deep dive more into Snowpack. Let me know. Thanks.